If there was any doubt about quarterback at Oklahoma after tonight, it's over. Caleb Williams is the starter going forward. So much drama building up over this. Is he going to split time with Rattler? Is Rattler going to start? Rattler left the team, this and that. A lot of stuff was blown out of proportion. I think there's some truth to some of the shenanigans or whatever may have happened last weekend, but you have the drama with the OU Daily spying on the practice and all this stuff. Caleb Williams is the starting quarterback at Oklahoma now. And not only did he play well, not only did he lead the team to victory, 18 of 23, 295 yards passing, four touchdowns in one game passing. Also had a rushing touchdown of like 41 yards. The dude was awesome. And he didn't fumble the snap on the shotgun center exchange. So we've made progress there. Offensively, when you start watching that game from the beginning, like the first couple drives, we're at 14 nothing early, and I know the defense is still an issue. Now, I will talk about the defense momentarily. Believe me, I have my thoughts. But our offense looks like what we thought it could have been, what it was supposed to be this year. It looks like an Oklahoma offense. We're throwing the ball downfield. Now, look, I'm going to nitpick here. Caleb has some issues with like underthrows and he's not leading guys, but as the game went on, it got better and he had some one-on-one matchups. And while he didn't get some, he got some pass interference calls that went his way. And you can argue whether they're ticky-tack or all the refs are in it for OU. You can do that all you want. The point is, we weren't seeing that all year. And our offense finally, we score 52 points, guys. I want to ask you, like, 52 points, which is normal for Oklahoma. When you think Oklahoma offense, oh, 52 points. Yeah, they could do that. But for this year, that was a pipe dream. And scoring 52 points, like as you watch the game, yeah, we'll score. There were a few moments here and there. Stogner dropped a TD early and all this. And then TCU's offense, like props to Max Duggan for playing with like an injured foot. And I'm sure he got it shot up with. They got that thing numbed up, and Zach Evans didn't play. That was huge, but obviously, like they're some of their big players, like Miller for TCU had a decent day. He made some plays in the passing game, but Quentin Johnson is a beast today. Seven catches, 185, three touchdowns. The touchdown he got at the late in the game, where it looked like Josh Eaton intercepted the ball and he just took it from him. That was a man play, and defense struggled tonight. Like DJ Graham went out early into concussion protocol, so OU was down three starters on the secondary. So there's a lot of frustration in my chat tonight. Not really shocked because there's a lot of frustration in my chat every week, but that you have to take into account some injuries. As bad as the defense played, looked at times. I know it sucked. There was some bad tackling. There were times where they made contact line of scrimmage. Guys were fighting forward and getting more extra yards. Make contact line of scrimmage, you gotta take guys down. I know I'm sitting here like in front of my webcam talking about it, but it's like that was frustrating at times tonight. Grinch like kept everything. The defense kept everything in front of them tonight. They were not going to get beat deep, so you saw a lot of plays where the corner is moving back and one receiver's going back and he's going back to help the safety, and meanwhile another wide receiver is just got all this cushion and they just take whatever like. TCU took whatever OU gave them, and it worked for a long stretches. It worked, but OU made some stops tonight when they had to. I'm getting comments like, "Oh, this is as bad as 2018. Oh my God, guys! Like, you have to put things in perspective. You want to go and whine about say it's bad as 2018? You go right ahead. I know I'm going to hear it in the comments. I heard it all in my chat tonight. But again, take into consideration who we're missing." Our two best corners were not playing for most. Like, Woody Washington's been out. We need him back. And DJ Graham is in concussion protocol. Thankfully, we play Kansas next week. And we probably won't need him if he has to miss another week. But man, it's just like we know that we need those two guys out there. You got to have like two really solid corners. And if you don't, it is going to be a long season. Like, if you thought tonight was bad. So. The front finally got some plays here and there. There was that really bad non-call on Benito in the end zone. Should have been a safety. Riley was not happy with that. They were finally able to manufacture some pressure at some points tonight. But overall, it was like a so-so performance defensively, injuries aside. So what can Grinch do to make some changes. Like, you know, they made a few changes here and there. You know, Deshaun White had the, you know, LaTrell McCutcheon once again forces a turnover. Deshaun White takes it down, tries to make the miracle dive, and lets go of the ball before he gets out of bounds and gives him a touchback. So just little learning moments that, again, didn't cost you the football game, but just you expect better from some upperclassmen like Deshaun White. It's like, dang, man, why'd you have to do that? But again, like, Brooks had a great night tonight as well. Mike Woods, like, guys, wide receivers were open down the field. It was fun to watch. And I'm going to talk about this too real quick, because this is going to be a topic, because Herb Street brought it up. So it's official now. I've said before, I say it again, like, tongue-in-cheek, I'll say Caleb Williams for Heisman. I'll say that tongue-in-cheek, Caleb Williams for Heisman, isn't he awesome? Kirk Herbstreit brought it up as, like, there's no one really in front right now that you would go, that guy, without question, is the Heisman front-runner. Because Bijan Robinson today looked like he could have taken it by the horns. It would have been his, but Texas threw up on themselves in the second half. Bryce Young at Alabama, he's okay. He puts up numbers, but, you know, losing to A&M on the road and not making plays when you have, like, all these little things. The Heisman Trophy has turned into best player on best team. And right now, you have undefeated Oklahoma, who's going to be in the top three of the AP poll tomorrow, and their quarterback, who was the hero last week against Texas, and had an amazing game tonight, on prime time with, again, Fowler and Herbstreit 2 weeks in a row. I'm not going to sit here and tell you he should be the favorite or he even should win the Heisman. Here's how I'm going to break it down, because I know some of you have already typed and put your comments and saying I'm stupid without even hearing the full, you know, my whole reasoning behind this, but that's fine. Here's where the Heisman talk becomes real. Caleb Williams has to play like he did last week and like he did tonight the rest of the season. He can't have a so-so game. The moment you have a so-so game, you're out of the club, and they're trying to find someone new. The writers and voters are desperate to try to find someone new, because all the preseason guys, like Radler and Howell, no, not happening. So when you have a guy that's that exciting, makes big plays, and it's like, but he only made an impact as of last week. Is it possible for a guy for only half a season, the most important half, mind you, to walk in? He won't have similar numbers, like, for season-long stats. I think it's possible he could get an invite to New York. Win it? There's a lot of other factors, a lot of other players who could make plays down the road who have played all year. But I think he can at least get an invite, potentially. Now, it all depends. Are they going to invite three? Will they invite five guys? I'm getting way ahead of myself on this. I'm not going to sit here and tell you he should win the Heisman. That is not what I'm saying. It would take performances like last week, tonight, throughout the rest of the season to get invited, to be a finalist. I think that's the ceiling for it. So, it was brought up by Herbstreit. It's being brought up by other people online. Caleb Williams is really good. It's 2 weeks in a row. He has to do this for the rest of the year. We'll see what happens in a few weeks, how real this could potentially look. But right now, it's a nice thought. It's fun to talk about, and everyone wants to talk about, man, we need a Heisman frontrunner. Caleb Williams is fun to talk about right now, but you can't realistically do it now. But I'll tell you, next year, preseason, like, you know how I feel about preseason September guys? They always don't tend to work out, unless you're like Baker. Baker is like a rare exception. I'll tell you what, next year hype, I'll be all on the Heisman hype for him next year. I promise you that. So hopefully playing Kansas, you know, whether you get some guys back next week for Tech, or the week after that, I mean, and get healthy, because we need Jalen Redmond back, because he's a very important piece. I think we got Isaiah Coe back tonight. I don't know how much he played, but we played a lot of young guys in the secondary, a lot of young guys, a lot of backups. We need to get Turner Yell was not playing tonight. You know, Woody Washington, DJ Graham. We need those guys back desperately. I promise you, this defense is not as bad as you think it is based on tonight's performance when they're healthy. But that's the thing about college football. A lot of guys are hurt. Most of Georgia's offense is hurt. They finally got guys like Darnell Washington back and everything, so they're still winning big. So you got to deal with injuries. It's part of the game. But guess what? Oklahoma has so far. They're 7-0, and they have a chance to win the Big 12 again and get in the playoff hunt. But you know they have Kansas next week. Thankfully, a scrimmage on the road. Anyway. That's all I got. I'll be back tomorrow. Talk about the AP poll, reacting to that. OU probably slides up to number 3, and even if they don't, who cares? But it's still fun to talk about like where teams are and how they did today. And Tennessee is driving down the field right now, and maybe they got a shot. Who knows? So anyway, that's all I got. Boomer Sooner. I'll catch y'all later.